So, once again, welcome to Shortcut Guide. And if you're new to this channel, we just learned how to use the software and do with them. And once again, I brought you a tutorial about how to use Holyrics. So, and in today's tutorial, I decided to talk about how to import a Bible into Holyrics. So, Holyrics comes with its own Bibles, but you can also import a Bible from outside. For example, the New Living Translation is not there. Other languages are not there, except for Espanol and Portuguese and some English, but other languages are not there. So, first of all, the version of Holyrics I'm using is this, version 2.240x64, and for let us go direct to the Bible section. Go to the Bible and then file, version and tools. So these are the different Bibles which come on Holyrics. You just download them. Once you have downloaded Holyrics on your PC, you should need to download this online. And they already come with Holyrics, but you just download. You have to be online to download them. So how do you download? You just come here and then you say download, especially when you're online. And you can search any kind of Bible which you want, but they are limited in number. So these are the different versions which I have, which I downloaded. And if you want to import a Bible into Holyrics, and this is the main reason why I did this video, you come here to version, yes, version, then you say that import Zephaniah XML Bible. When you say like that, you come to Holyrics. It takes you to your Holyrics place. Then you download the Bible. For example, when you don't have the Bible already put into the Holyrics mode, I'm going to take you step by step on how to download it online. Then you bring it into Holyrics. So when you go to our web browser, you can search for Zephaniah XML, the language which you want. For example, you want the Uganda Bible. You search for it, and after searching for it, any website which comes, for example, me GitHub is one which came. You open it, and then when there is readme, there is. Here we can download the Bible. Double click on it, and then just double click on it. Then you make sure that you download a raw file of the Bible, and the work will be there. Then you say that you should keep it, though it gives a warning because of the coding issues. So when you, and after that, it will be stored in your downloads automatically. Once you have downloaded the Bible, you come here to downloads, and you click on the Bible which you downloaded. You copy work control C. And then after copying it, you come to local disk C, Holyrics. Then you paste it anywhere. Your Bible will be seen here when you come back to Holyrics. So when you go back to Holyrics, you can see, and then we say that file, that in version, then we come to import XML Bible. Then this is the Bible which you pasted in. If your Bible does not have errors or does not have mistakes, it will directly be already imported. But if it has mistakes like mine, for example, the website I downloaded from, this Bible shows that it has mistakes. For example, the errors and the details of the mistake, they are duplicate what? Files, 1 Samuel 3:1, and so I'm going to make sure that we try to correct these errors, and you must make sure that you have downloaded an application known as Notepad plus plus. But not worry, because Windows 10 and Windows 11 comes with this on Notepad. But I downloaded another software so that it can help me to remove errors automatically. But you can use that one, which already comes with what, with Windows 10. So you come, you open your File Explorer, then you come back to this Holyrics application, and you come here to Bible. Yes, this Bible here, which you copied in, then you say that you right click on it, then you right click on it, then it will say that you can open with a web browser and everything, but you come here to open with Notepad. This one is one which comes with Holyrics already. Which comes already with Windows 10 and 11, but you can you can also download this advanced one because it helps in coding and everything. You open it, and after opening it, these are the codings which are already there. These are how it will appear here. So you should go back to Holyrics and look for the version to look for where the mistake was. For example, when I come, let me first try to import it once again, and I see this is the Bible. Importing it, you say that first Samuel this it has a problem. So what are you going to do? It may take some time, because you come back here to Notepad, it may take some time, but you need to do it. So what you need to do is try to do what? To reduce this information one by one. These are the books until I reach where First Samuel is. You can see that here is where my First Samuel is, but this Bible is in Uganda, that's why you can see that First Samuel. And so where is the mistake? Remember, there are 66 books in the Bible, and they have arranged them from, this is Genesis, the first book, second book, third book, fourth book, fifth book, sixth book, seventh book, eighth book, and ninth book, and ninth book. So this is first and second Samuel. You can see that there is a mistake. Instead of putting here 9 and here 10, they put 9. So you correct this mistake. For example, you just wrap here and you put 10. And after that, you just say like Control S over save. And after saving, you can just first close it, and after closing it, try to import it again like this, Zephaniah, Bible, then you come and import the same Bible. So you can see that it has other mistakes, but if you download from our website, which is well known and which has no mistakes, it will give you a great what version. So you can see that it has mistakes in Matthew 21 and the 40 verse this, and also I don't know which Bible is which version is this, but I don't know this book, but I can recognize it when I come back to Notepad. Let me first go back to the browser again, then I right click on the same Bible, then I do like edit it with again with what, Notepad. And after that, so I was in Samuel, I can go on closing this box until I reach Matthew. You may see it as a difficult work, but it is really worth it. I'm now in Ezra. Close the book. Now in Psalms, close the book. I'm in Isaiah, close the book. it may take your time, but it is really worth it because you want the Bible, you want the version of the Bible which you want. So close the book. This is Matayo. This is the book which I wanted. So when I go back to Holyrics, so I can see that it is Matthew 21, 45. This is where the mistake is. And then I can start to close to chapter by chapter. Close the chapter in that book until I reach 45. Close the chapter until I reach 21. Let me try to scroll down. Until I reach 21. Close the chapter. 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18. Is it 12? Let me first check again. It is 21. It is Matthew 21, 45. Am I in Matthew? I look for 21. Why is it like it's ending on 15? Let me first check. Matthew 21. Let me close 17. I close once again until I reach 21. So I must look for the 45th Bible chapter. So you must have an application having the same Bible on your phone so that you cannot make mistake. For example, again, they have said that on the 45th chapter there is a mistake, then you correct this mistake. You first check on your Bible on your phone, then you, so that you can make sure that you are correct. For example, this ends with what, 46. You correct that, and after correcting that, for the remaining errors, for example from this book, you can correct it by yourself because you're not going to have the same mistake. This is just a tutorial to show you how to do it. And after that, you save, Control S over, you can say, come here to file. Then you say that save as over, you just save. And after saving that, you can come back to your, Holyrics. Then you click here that okay. Then, and after clicking okay, you come here to version. Then export as a Fania Bible. You export the version, the Bible which you had. You have corrected all the mistakes. For example, when you do like that, so it will ask you ID. So what is an ID? An ID, it is, for example, here they are saying that KJV and NIV. This is the name which will be written up there. I can say that Luga, because it is a Luganda Bible. So for the language, you can choose the language from here, but I would prefer it to be like in English. Let me just answer that. And then this is the name, this is the sweet description. So you can write any description here. For example, your email or anything like that, if they want to know you. So let me write here my email so that if you have anything or you have your Bible to correct, You can send me a message and I will correct it for you, maybe for free, especially for people who have subscribed to my channel. So let me write here my email so that maybe you may contact me if you're willing. Musa, my email is Musa Thing Soft at gmail.com. If you want to contact me, that is apparently my email. This is the description. For example, here they can say that Bible version this, and then they continue giving the description, copyright, and everything. That is the thing which is going to appear here. So when I say like this, I say Uganda Bible. Bible, so be capital, and all of that, and you say okay. So you say that it is done, and after it is done, you can come here and you come to English because you selected your Bible to be in English. Here it is, and then you put it there. You can see that our LLG Luga has been put here in the Uganda Bible. And then it is among these versions which I have. You can see that it is a different language. That is Uganda. So you can put any, you can import any kind of Bible in Holyrics. If you want more videos about this, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. So I have a playlist, a full playlist about how to use Holyrics and all the things all about Holyrics. So in the nearby future, I'm planning to show you how to stream live and using Holyrics. But as for now, that is it for now. Shout out to that best friend who subscribed to my channel and also asked me about how to import a Bible into Holyrics. So thanks so much for watching.